Card and we're gonna pray and we're gonna do release blessings in the atmosphere. We're gonna expect God to manifest. Y'all, I get happy by myself, right? Hey, sweetheart, I love y'all, sister, so much. I want to share with y'all what the Lord is really saying about you today. One thing you got to understand is the Lord says, what I have on my mind concerning you is to simply be good to you. Like, we're going to get on one accord and we're going to pray. Heaven going to fall, come down, outpour, and God will be glorified. At the same time, God will be blessing you at the same time. Let's pray. Dear Father, in the name of Jesus, oh, we acknowledge your presence, Jehovah, that you are our Heavenly Father. We acknowledge you, Jesus, that you are our Savior. You are our Messiah. You are our Lord. And we know that, God, we have to allow you to lord over and rule over. So, Lord, we yield, we submit, and we surrender, and we say to you, God, dear Lord, be Lord over our lives, that you may bring glory to the Father. And we acknowledge the power of the Holy Spirit, because he is God in the Spirit here in the earth. This is so important for you to know today, because it's going to take you to your next level in life, your next step. And you're going to find out that nothing happened in your life and it was by accident. No. God either allowed it or permitted it. Because you see, Lucifer, I always remember, put defeat before his name. That defeated lying devil called Lucifer, he already been defeated. So we're not going to focus on him. But what we're going to do, we're going to cancel every plan of Lucifer. We're going to cancel every assignment of Lucifer. We're going to cancel all the works of the devil, because of my Bible tell me that, Lord, I can have it by myself. Well, Jesus said it like this. The works of the devil already been destroyed. So therefore, what are you fighting if something been destroyed already? Now, I'm going to tell you what you're fighting. It's that faith that you're fighting for right now, because the enemy know that if he take your faith from you, he going to steal your dreams, steal your vision, your business, your family, your home. But the devil can't have nothing, because if we don't give him permission to touch, we don't even give him permission to come around our property, our premises, our territory. We don't give him permission. We take authority in the name of Jesus. What authority do you have, Pastor Stoddy? You have the authority of the word of the living God. This message is going to heal your heart and it's going to set you free. I promise you, guarantee, you won't be the same, because the Lord always doing something brand new. He's always changing. Now, let me tell you something. We call off an increase, right? Remember this. I know I said it before, because increase do not come without a change. You see that very thing that you are afraid of? That's what you got to muscle your strength up, and you got to step out, because that's where your very miracle lies, right there. And it's only one thing keeping you from crossing. Got your back, baby. Yeah, you get the last word. You and God. But see, that the only thing that's stopping you from crossing over, oh, this is good to me, is a spirit. Don't just say a word. It's a spirit that's called fear. And fear is none other. Remember, is doubt and unbelief. If that ever happened to you, that's why I tell you every time, every day, always create an atmosphere for the presence of the Lord to just rule over whatever is going on. It's like an aroma, the scent of his presence. You have to allow it to happen. You have to create that atmosphere. You got to not only create the atmosphere, you got to be willing to stand still and wait upon the Lord. But let me tell you this here. You know, this is for you that think that God is finished with you. God's not finished with you, baby. God just not starting with you. Who would you say that for, Pastor Star? Because of the fact, here it is. He gave Abraham a promise at 75. Who gonna tell you that you're going to be the nation? Come on now, you all. Who going to have the audacity at 75 years old? And then God got the audacity to say, you're going to be the father of many nations? Oh, but that brother did not waver in his faith. You cannot waver, and I'm going to show you why. This is the year. Between this year and next year is 2 years. All you have to do is store up, because God has already created a pathway for you to go forward and to go forth. But you can't be afraid. I'm going to show you why. Listen to this wisdom. Not only it seemed like it would be crazy, like, what? Abraham? What? Yeah, Abraham. Yes, yes. So you stop it talking about, oh, you know what? No. Nothing get over close. Let me tell you something. You who are over 50, you start saying these words like this, because I'm going to tell you, if you start saying, I'm 45 years old, I'm 50 years old, you know what you call it? You call it oldness to come upon you, and you're going to start looking old. Now, if you want to be honest about it and be real, baby, I'm 50 years young, I'm 45 years young, I'm 60 years young. What you're calling to you is youth. You see, it's the words that come out of your mouth that birth forth the image of that what you speak, because God is going to honor just what you say. It's whatever you believe that's going to give power to anything. So everything going to be left up to you. You can't blame God. You got to blame yourself. You see, only the ignorance is the one that would not know this. But you see, you that have the knowledge of the living God, God will hold you accountable of what he's saying to you right now. How about this right here? Who in the world going to gonna be 80 years old and talking about I'ma lead all these needy people. Oh, Moses, oh, you forgot about him. Stop. You get that time to run out for you. Time just started for you. You're just getting ready to blossom, to flourish, to bloom. You're getting ready. God always moves in ways and situations to where it's like Gideon would be like, Lord, you gonna choose the weakest of the clan? God said, yeah, boo. You're the one I want. Because I don't have to worry about you taking none of my glory. Hear this wisdom. Then let's go to Paul. Paul, you mean to tell me, this brother gonna write over half of the New Testament. People may think that because, let me tell you something, cooking. The Bible was written, but watch this here now. They didn't write it overnight. You can't write what you haven't experienced. See, Paul had to experience. See, the word of the living God is only human being experience. And they wrote it under the unction, about the unction of the Holy Spirit, which breathed life upon it to make it become alive to you. That's why God is saying, hold on, baby. It just started for you. The flourishing of this thing, the blossoming of this thing, the fruitfulness of this thing. Oh, but God got you. That's a supernatural move going on right now in the midst of you right now. All you have to do is stop, slow down, and pay attention. Come on, just breathe in and breathe out and say, Lord, have thine way. Well, what about Paul? You think that all the hell he been through, that he just like, let me get up and let me write over half of the New Testament. Tell the devil, me and God say, go to hell. Why you been saying, tell the devil to go to hell? What? Why you won't tell him to go to hell? And that's where he going? Hell wasn't made for me or you. Hell was made for the devil and his angels. So why not? If he can remind you of your past, why you can't remind him of his future? That's where he going. He jealous of you anyway, because you standing in a place where he once stood. He standing, you are in the presence of the Almighty God. He lost that privilege. He lost that access. He lost that place. And now you got it. And now he jealous of you. And now he's saying to himself, well, I know I can't curse them. Are you in the Holy Ghost? He said, I know I can't curse them. Watch this here now. He said, but I know a way. That's the devil. I know a way that they can curse themselves. Watch the Holy Ghost prove it to you. So therefore, what you sending for business style? Paul was like 68 plus years of age when he wrote the book of Corinthians. Now, mind you, he wrote over half of the New Testament. And that was the bar. He didn't even walk with Jesus. Oh, let me get up out this chair. That's the bar. Just put it back a little bit for me, Cricket. That's that. Mm-hmm, just a little bit. Look, that's, you know what? That's the bar. Just put it back a little bit. There you go. Right there. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry. But yeah, that's the one, Cookie, that, oh God, I just so happy. Y'all better understand this here. Let me tell you something. This man here, see, you can't write what you haven't experienced. Everybody have a book in them. The books that God graced me to write. That's my experience. The book that's in you, that's your experience. And what's going to happen, God breathed on it. That's what make it afresh. That's what make it anew. To where about you, because like, you know what? Long as I got God on my side, I'm going to prove it to you. Baby, you just not begun. This thing just not begun for you. God done this already. What's it now? And you think about, like, what? Well, I thought right after Pentecost. No. You know what Pentecost is, right? That was a festivity going on, right? It was a feast. Everybody from all over just coming in. And they were just enjoying the harvest that God has blessed them with. Oh, my God. It happened on the day of Pentecost. Because my Bible says that Jesus came. And my Bible says that he was here for like 40 days. That's after the resurrection. The Bible says he came back. But the Bible also lets me know. Ooh, are you happy, God? The Bible also let me know that when he ascended, the Bible said, look, boys, I tell y'all something. He said, I'm not going to leave you alone, and I'm not going to leave you by yourself. I got somebody coming. His name is the Holy Ghost. He's going to be your comforter. He's going to be your lead. He's going to be your guide. He's going to give you direction. He's going to give you the peace. He's going to let you know his way. He's going to govern over you if you allow him. He'll govern all over you. He fulfilled the word of the living God through you if you allow him to do it. If you allow him to love through you, he'll love through you. If you, whatever you allow him to do, that's what he's going to do. You hear the Holy Spirit talking to you, huh? So my Bible says that Paul, you do your study. What man like 68 years old? And you think it's stuff going to happen overnight? Nothing going to happen overnight. You got that microwave faith. You better sit yourself down and allow God to do this work in you, because of the fact my Bible says that he's the author and the finisher. That means everything that God started in you, he's going to finish. You better hear the Holy Ghost. And I declare and I decree it in Jesus' name that not one step will be lost. Baby, you're going to be on target. You're going to be ahead. You're going to go forth. You're going to move forward. You're going to say, God, I'm so grateful to hear this wisdom. Lord, I know it's always your season. Why? Because of the fact everybody have what you call different levels of faith. And you see, my faith and your faith should always be called seasonal faith. Woo! That means I believe God for whatever. I believe God for it don't matter anything, whatever it may be. That's when that faith become perfected. That's when that faith become, come on, God talking to you anyhow. And see, a lot of you all got that kind of faith, but you don't know how to exercise what you got. All you got to do is just believe. Glory be to God. Believe in God and believe in yourself. And you're going to see the power of God move on your behalf. You see the power of God manifest on your behalf. You can see the power of God show forth the manifestation of the substance that he, you know what? Not only what you ask him for, but what you believe him for. That's what's going on right now. And I got to give it to you, you know, like God gave this book. See this book here? You got to have it. I'm going to just give you a little snip of it. Watch this here now. And look at God. God is so awesome, Cookie. Look. Now here God have us touring with the book, city to city, state to state. So you know what? Keep your eyes and your ears open, because we can pop up where you are at any time. But let me tell you this here. See this right here? It's going to balance you. It's going to level you off. It's going to let you know, I've been free. I'm free indeed. It's the Lord thy God that governs over me. I hear what my God got to say about it. The Bible said it like this here in the book of Isaiah. The Bible said that Isaiah couldn't even see the Lord until Uzziah died. You see, a lot of you are, oh, Jesus. You mean to tell me that Uzziah had to die before Isaiah? Y'all better talk to me or what you gonna do. You know, Isaiah declared it out his own mouth. You know, when Uzziah died, then Isaiah began to see the Lord. Really? So you better get them Uzziahs out your way. Who are the Uzziahs? Whoever's in your ear, whoever's in your way, whoever blocking you. But the main defeated foe behind it is Lucifer. You better get him in his place. His place is under your feet. But I'm trying to tell you something that lets you know, baby, you are ripe in what God is getting ready to do in your life. You are ripe. You better hear the Holy Ghost. But because cooking with something ripe and it's not used at that moment for that purpose, it'll rot. But ain't nothing God gave you, baby. Go unheard or unnoticed, and it will not rot itself in nothing. It's gonna be just like Jesus. Not one of his bone was broken, and he did not decay. That's a good word. In the cage. You know why? But you know what? Bless me so much, Cricket. You know, think about this for a while. I'm gonna give you two scriptures. Think about this for a while. You know, you think about, okay, Cricket was talking to me, and I said, you know what, baby? That makes a whole lot of sense. Listen to this here, you know. The word of the living God said, watch this here now, that 1,000 years is one day to the Lord. Y'all better, what you gonna do? 1,000 years is one day to the Lord. Now, you read in that Bible, so you think you know God. No, you know, baby. You may think that you up here at God ankle, God here. Baby, you still at the toe. You ain't going nowhere. That's for me and you. Are you hearing the Holy Spirit? But you listen to this wisdom. Now, if you know that, if the Bible said God declared 1,000 years is like one day to him. All right. Now, if God created the universe, all right, in 6 days, in 6 days, on the seventh day, he rests. Okay, you're looking at it. See, let me help you who be trying to figure God out. You can't figure this man out. Because if God said 1,000 years is one day to the Lord, did that mean 7 days could be 7 million years? Catching and run with it, sweetheart. And guess what? I ain't even charge you for it. It's free wisdom. God giving it to you so you can know who you are. So you can stay ahead of the devil. So the devil, and we're going to talk about it. It's called condemnation. I want you to understand something. That it ain't nobody could touch you. Can't nobody harm you. Can't nobody do anything. They can influence you if you allow them. Now, the weak gonna follow the weak, but the strong gonna follow the stronger. And the Bible said, if that low down, good for nothing Lucifer can't take the strong man out, he can't touch nothing that belong to you. You see, it don't mean just because the fact my husband is the head, or your husband is the head, it don't take nothing from them at all. It just simply means that you may be most spiritually mature All right, let's get it right now. Let's get it right. Because if no, you're not the head over that man. That man is your head. You get that, you better get it and get it right. It just perhaps, maybe, you know, God is saying that you spiritual mature. You know what I'm saying? And that's why he will hold you out accountable, whoever you are, accountable, because of the fact the truth that you know is the truth God has come looking for. He wants you to do just what he promised. Oh God. But listen to this. Now you think about power. These things happen, Cookie. Right. But it didn't happen overnight. Right. And a lot of people, they want to give up. Like, I'm 30 years old. I'm 40 years old. Stop saying that word, old. Making yourself look like the fact that you some old somebody. Ain't no old. You want me to show you what's old? Give me an old piece of cloth or an old dress, and I'm going to tear it apart for you. Because don't nothing get old but clothes till you hear the Holy Spirit. And I tell you what, if you stitch that up good enough and press it, it'll look brand new too, right? Okay, but here it goes. Yeah, you're going to have to stop doing this one thing. You're going to have to stop condemning yourself. All right. You know I must love y'all, right, to be in this heat. But that's all right, though. But here it is, wisdom. Because of the fact, I'm going to show you what the Bible said. No weapon formed up against you shall prosper. But I think you missed that very little keen little word in there that Isaiah wrote. Mm-hmm. He said, whatever Bridget condemned, call your own name out. Whatever Bridget condemned, then Lord the Rubaya. God himself said, I will condemn it. In other words, you're sitting around waiting for God to condemn, you know, this and condemn that and condemn the fault finders, condemn the haters, and condemn the people. God, you get out of the elementary stage, okay? And come on up a little bit higher so you can enjoy the greater things of my Father. Because my Bible says, if my word abide in you and God himself abide in you, my Bible said, ask what you will and it shall be done. So a lot of you all, you know, you haven't been, you know, you've been asking, but you've been asking the right way. You better hear the Holy Ghost. Because every time you ask, you go back and you ponder on it and you begin like, I just don't see it. But go back to the wisdom that God told you. If 1,000 years is one day to God, and God created everything in 6 days, and he rested on the seventh day, you think you got him figured out, huh? No, you don't have God figured out, baby. That could be 7 million years. And you want to quit? Oh, no, you're not going to quit. No, you're going to do everything. You're going to complete it, and you're going to finish it. Now, look at this here, thank you, my baby. Now, look at this here. You see this book right here? Been on tour. I'm just going to give you a glimpse of it. Watch. A many questions was asked, you know. Because a lot of people that God had me to interview, you all go back and watch it on my Facebook page, Bridgestone Ministry. A many people are, you want it? Okay, yeah. But a many people, you know, was talking so down on Christians. And I want to understand why you're leaving your faith? Why? What is happening right here? Everybody was saying the same thing. Everybody was saying, Christians too judgmental. Christians always finding fault. Christians always rejecting. Christians don't even want to, you know, they're always trying to pull out and not realizing that you too have imperfections all over you, sweetheart. Let me break it down to you. That means that nothing is perfect concerning you. It's your spirit. When you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and personal Savior, you know how I go. My Bible says you confess with your mouth, believe in your heart. God raised Jesus from the dead. The Bible says, doubt you'll be saved. But no, you're trying to look like, oh, you got to put that on. Oh, you got to put that on. Oh, you got to eat this. Oh, you can't eat that. Oh, you can't dance. Oh, you can't. What you? Did I not tell you the other day? Jesus made this wine, right? I don't be arguing with folks. Talking about where it was unfermented. I don't give a word what it was. It was wine. And if Jesus, let me tell you something. And when he decided to join in, you got to study this for yourself. You don't think Jesus, why? Jesus didn't come in our spirit. Jesus came in flesh like me and you. And then when, and Cookie, you know how they be dancing? They dance a certain way. But see now, our culture, you don't dance like that. You dance with everything. Just everything, y'all. Everything. No, it's all right. I love to dance. Look, balance. Watch. I love that you got that part right here. Look at this here. Balance. Watch. I love it. Uh-huh. I love it. Good. Thank you, Cookie. All right. Let me tell you something about this balance. You see, the reason why many Christians are unbalanced is because of the fact once they get saved, they try to be all spiritual in a natural world. All right. For you to get the revelation of it, you have to get your book. You can go to Amazon, TBN Publishing Company, which is Trilogy. Yeah. .com. Get your book and buy enough for everybody else because everybody needs to be set free. Yeah, you know what? We just may meet us on the road because of the fact, you know, Right. Because the fact God is taking this thing now from city to city, state to state, and to even over to into the other country. Because I was just talking to the young lady from London. And I'm like, okay, you know what? When God graced that timing, it's a time. Lord, have mercy. I get so happy. Listen. All right, here you go, right here. Watch. I bet you ain't ever paid attention to this. Two simple things. Oh, that went feel good. Mm-mm. But in Isaiah 51, he says, pull up for me, baby. And let me read it to him. Just in case that you need to be reminded. Just in case. Because it's time for you to get up off your little romper. And you need to do what's in your heart. What's in your heart? You know, the only thing that's between you and your future are you and what God promised you. The only thing that's in between that's stopping you is fear. Fear. Mm-hmm. Go. Look at 54 and 17. Find it for me. And then I want you to compare these two scriptures. I'm going to let you go. Because let me tell you something. God has created a pathway for you so great. Favor just resting all over everything concerning you. Because the favor God has placed upon you. But look at this here. Now watch this. It's not that's what this baby's saying on this song. No weapon formed against her will prosper. Well, you see, don't, in other words, you wasting your time trying to figure out what's happening in somebody else's life. You better worry about yourself. Don't worry about who. Lord, have mercy. God got Bridget. It's a sure thing, too. He got Bridget. Watch this here now. The Bible says this here in Isaiah. Watch this. 54. Write it down. Isaiah 54 and 17. He says, no weapon that is formed against you shall prosper in every tongue. I like that. So that's why you got to stand. Oh, you got to get up. But you got to create the atmosphere. And you got to invite God in every morning. Let him be the priority of your life every day. And then the other part of the day, before not even the nightfall, God covers you all the way. Even when you're sleeping still in your bed, God's still watching over you. But the scripture says like this here. No one will form against you. Watch this. And nothing will prosper. And then he said, in every tongue that shall rise against you in judgment, thou shalt condemn it. Stop right there. It's nowhere in this scripture where God said, I'm going to condemn it. He only going to condemn it when you condemn it. If you don't condemn it, God is not going to condemn it. You got to rise up in the power and authority of the Holy Ghost. And you got to say, Father, I condemn every word, every thought, every assignment, every report, every evil defeated fall of the earth. Oh, you got to say, Father, in the name of Jesus, by the authority of your word, I condemn the words of the devil. I condemn the plans of the devil. I condemn the assignment of the devil. I condemn illness. I condemn sickness. I condemn poverty. I condemn ignorance. I condemn it. And the list goes on. You condemn it. And when you condemn it, watch God. That bad boy stands up. You better hear the Holy Ghost. He stands up and he don't back down. He said, because virtue, whatever you condemn, woo, I'm going to condemn it. It's in the Bible. Read it for yourself. And you go, watch it. Watch. He said that, oh, Jesus, I missed it. Come on, Cookie. Get it back for me. So I can make sure they get it all. So I got one more scripture. You know, you got to go in there. It's a different when you read the Bible. So you got to hear the word, read the word, study the word, meditate on the word. And then you do the word. It comes by observation, interpretation, evaluation, and application. All these things play very, very, very valuable importance in your life. You need this. You need it. You better stop out. Let you know what? Like the young man said. Listen to this, Cookie. Like if we don't have water, we get dehydrated, right?
Right.
And water is so pure and clear and clean, right?
Right.
Okay. All right. But the only time we want to drink water is when you get dehydrated. A lot of us anyway. Well, that's how God feel. God feel like, okay, oh yeah, you just want me now because of the fact you need me. But you didn't want to talk to me yesterday because of the fact you thought that you was the boss. You the man that got it going on. No. I need him. I can't eat without him. I can't sleep without him. And nothing I can do without him. I got to hurry up. Now watch this. And every tongue that shall rise against you. Let me tell you right now. Reverse the curse right now. Reverse the curse of every defeated word. All right. Watch this here now. He said, look up. Every tongue that rise against you in judgment, thou shalt condemn. This is the heritage of the servant of the Lord, and the righteousness is of me, thus said the Lord. God has already gave a way for you to escape. Already. God, you, God, what you mean? Jesus didn't come down here and invade that bad boy. Lord came down here to redeem. He came down here to put you back in your rightful place. He came down here to connect you back with the Father. He came down here. He came down here that we may be called and we may become the righteousness of my Father. What you mean, Pastor Scott? God talking to you. Don't you put your hands on the computer wherever you at. That means you are right now in right standing with God. Even with your mess up and your mess up. Why are you saying that, Pastor Scott? Because the fact the realm of the soul, that's where the imperfections are. That's why you got the fire. Get in that word. That's why you got to stay in that word and meditate on that word. Because of the fact that you meditate and listen to the Holy Ghost. God's not telling you you can't have you can't live your life or you can't do this. No. Let me tell you, that's under the law. The Bible said, Paul wrote it. Paul said, listen up. It's the law. It's the law of the spirit. You know what does, look again. What's the purpose of a law? How you say that? To regulate things. To govern over things. Set things in order. Lord, have mercy. You're sitting around there, you've been quoting that scripture all your life and not realizing that God is saying, I'm waiting on you. You letting it happen. You letting it go on. And tell you something. Let me tell you something. The devil make a behind of you if you let him with your mind. You see what I'm saying? Don't you let nobody be dumping all that mess on you. Let me tell you something. If somebody come to you once and they say, I need prayer. Okay, baby. They come to you twice. I need prayer. Okay, that's the second time. They come to you. I need prayer. That's the third time. Now, but they're dealing with the same situation. Because of the fact they want to burden you down. Don't you let that happen to you. Don't you let nobody come in and burden you down. Don't you let nobody come in and steal your joy. Don't you let nobody come in. You tell that person. You tell it because it's a spirit that's behind that mess. That's why I say you tell that slip foot defeated lying devil. Not talk about the person, but it's a spirit behind the person. And that person got to grow up. You know, if you ready to get out of it, you don't stop talking about it. Are you hearing the Holy Ghost? When you ready to get all but cooking. When you ready to get out of something, you don't talk no more. The most powerful thing that God graced a human being to have is silence. That make the loudest noise. That mean, baby, honey, it's showdown time. Ain't no more playing no game. God got this here. Now watch this. I wonder how many people realize that they got to condemn it. You got to rise up in the morning. You got to condemn. Rise up in the rock of fire. Father, in the name of Jesus. Lord, I come in your name. Condemning everything that's trying to rise up against you. Call your family name out. Call your church name out. Call your inheritance out. Did God say this thing was preserved for the inheritance of the saints? God put that. Ow! Jesus! Even the inheritance of the wicked is preserved for the saints. You better start acting out in the word of the living God. Stand up like the Holy Ghost tell you to do. Stand up and say, Lord, I take authority over this. I take authority over that. I condemn it. That's the key word. You got to keep it in your mouth. I condemn all lies. I condemn all assignments of the devil. I condemn all the lies of the devil. I condemn every roadblock. I condemn it, Lord. I condemn the devil's assignment. I condemn the devil's plan. I condemn the devil's work. I condemn it. Glory be to God. I condemn every word that the devil try to use anybody, Lord God, to speak against you or myself. Take authority by the power of the word, by the power of the blood, by the power of the Holy Ghost, by the power in the name of Jesus. It's prompted by your faith that God is moving. I must prove it to you. I'm going to give you the next scripture to go on with. You take it and you digest it and you feast on it and you feast on it and you feast on it because God is doing so. This work is so great. Baby, it ain't time to slow down. You better stop acting like, don't let that come out of your mouth. Don't let that come out of your mouth. It's time for me to slow down. No, it's not. It's not. Watch this here now. But they just said, no weapon formed against me shall prosper. What about the rest of it? You forgot about that? You know why? Because of the fact the enemy didn't want them to know it. Are you hearing the Holy Ghost? The enemy didn't want them to know it, Cookie. So what he did, he just let them get like a piece, that little glimpse of it. No weapon formed against me shall prosper. But you forgot, he was still talking. He said in every word that the devil come and try to speak out of his mouth against you. Condemn it, glory. Oh, that's when everything become a boomerang. That's when things become the reversion of the curse. That's when things become to repeat it. Oh, that's when things become, oh my God, begin to say, oh, stop, hold up, baby. You can't go to bridges. You better find your own to go to. See, you got to know God for yourself. But listen to this here. I got to let you go. But watch this here now. Watch this here now. Okay, here we go. Now, I was reading. Let's get a find it for you again. Because You didn't go to Romans 14 and 22. That's where I want to go. 14 and that's where I want to go. 14 and 22. Well, watch this now. Watch it. Hear, listen, obey it. Are you hearing the Holy Spirit? You so fearful of people. What's wrong with you? What's wrong with you? A people? A people is a people. And people do just what people do. They live. Only one is one race of mankind. Am I right? Cooking? You know? It's just, oh, God. I got a baby. Look. Right here, look what he said in Romans 14, 22. Has thou faith? Watch this now. Because see, the devil going to challenge your faith every day. He going to make you feel guilty, unworthy. I don't have no reason, you know, that I should be even existing. I'm so that you know what that happened. You and God caught up with the world. You became a world, not a word thinker, a world thinker. Thinking about what the world is saying when it comes to you. Why do you want to give somebody that type of power over your life? Why? You better put yourself in check. You better ask God to forgive you for your ignorance. Because God is doing something so powerful. I've been saying it every day. It affects my blood, my body, my bone. It affects, glory be to God, because my broken blood. I said, Father. And he said, you don't understand it. He said, but just receive it. Anytime the power of the living God rise up upon you, anytime the power of the living God, in your presence, you know the presence of the power of God is all around you. You've been saying, Lord, what's going on? You know it's something great. It's bigger than you. You know it's great. And you can't figure it out. Well, God said like this to tell you. Just say, Lord, I receive. I receive whatever you're doing, God. I receive it. But look at this here now. Now here go Paul. Isaiah, you know, the Bible. Now watch this here now. You know, it's not like a storybook. It's not written in chronological order. But this is the thing. You know, you can be studying one scripture, and then the next verse could be 700,000 years later. You know, you gotta understand, baby. You can't figure this God out I'm talking about. Come on. But look at this right quick before I let you go. The Bible said in 14. Let me get my glasses. My little reading glass, all right? Look at this here. He said in Romans 14, 22. Has thy faith? And then he got a question mark. He got a question mark behind it. He got a question mark. He said, has thy faith? What faith? Faith in the word of the living God by the authority and the power of the word and the blood in the name of Jesus Christ. Faith is something, baby, that you cannot explain because it's unseen, but yet it stands its ground and it stands its ground. And saying, I shall not, 10 toes down, baby, and I shall not be moved. Moved from what? From my faith. You don't know where. But everything God promised you, you're going to walk right into it. But look at this here. He got a question mark. He said, has thy faith? You still got faith for it, huh? Look, God talking. He said, have it to thyself and before God. Dog it. You. You've been trying to prove everything to everybody. That's because the fact you haven't made yourself become a believer. You don't believe in your own dream. You don't believe in your own vision. Matter of fact, you don't believe in you. Is this the word of the living God? He said, has thy faith? In other words, you got faith for it? God, Jesus. In other words, you got faith for it? Huh? You got faith for it? But look what he go on and say, look. And he go, oh my God. He said, have it to thyself before God. Well, I wonder why you trying to go around and express and explain to people and try to let them, you know, see it the way you see it and da-da-da. Shut your mouth up. You talk too dead blank much. Let me tell you how I know about it. My Bible tell me Elizabeth. Zechariah didn't want to get on one accord with God. God bound that brother mouth clean up. And said, you will not prevent what I'm doing in Bridget's life. You will not prevent, call your own name out. You will not prevent the miracles. You will not prevent the breakthrough. You will not prevent it, Lucifer. You lying, defeated, lying devil. You're a defeated liar, Lucifer. You will not, my Bible said, the messengers, you see that angel? Mm-hmm. See, they think angel is just a word. But that's the title. The Bible said it. God shut Zechariah's mouth down. And he was like, And that's how God gonna do with a lot of folks cooking. They're gonna want to say something evil, but because of the fact you took the because you took your rights back, and you begin to say, "Oh, I got the power to condemn your words, condemn every lie, condemn every defeated thought. I'm going to cook it." Jesus Christ, they can't even utter it out of their mouth. Because why? Because now you know your rights. Now you know the power and authority of the word. Now you know the power and authority of the blood. Now you know the power and authority of the Holy Ghost. Now you know the power and authority of your faith. Now you know God in ways that you didn't know God before. Well, God is telling you right now, listen up. He said, listen up. When you move, guess what? God said, listen, when he said, when I move, you move just like that. Look at the Holy Ghost. Watch what I'm He said, oh, cookie, this. I'm telling me, girl. Oh my God. Nobody said it. He said, Have it to yourself before God. Well, why are you trying to go there? And nobody want to hear me. And nobody want to believe me. And nobody want to hear me. And shut your blame mouth up. Well, nobody need to hear that thing but you. And until you hear it, ain't nobody going to hear. If you're speaking it out before time, it's called premature. They try to come in and kill it. Some things you gotta hold your peace and listen, cookie, and let it manifest on its own. Mm-hmm. Let God do this work. Watch. He said, have it to thyself. Watch it. Have it to thyself. Read it. Have it to thyself before God. Mm-hmm. Then he go, happy. You see, joy is divine. Wow. Happiness is a choice. Uh-huh. I chose to be happy. I choose to be happy, cookie. You ought to choose to be happy. And you are depend everything. Listen up, cookie. My happiness, it comes from the Lord. That's just bottom line. It comes from the Lord, cookie. Because of that, why? He's the center of my joy. That means I look to him for everything, all things, everything, you name it, I look to him for it. I don't look to no man. God will use a man to do what he promised you, but you got to look to God. Am I right? But look, check this out. But cookie, this blessed me so much. He said, look. He said, watch that. He said, happy is you that condemn it. Not yourself. God dog it. You are your greatest, biggest enemy. You see that, huh? You are your greatest, biggest enemy. I didn't write this. I did not. The man named Paul, who was once a murderer, I cannot get it. How can they take the whole Bible and believe it? But if you happen to fall, they can't hear from you, but you can hear from the murderer who wrote about the book. I don't get it, cookie. But that's all right, though. You don't have to. The only person got to get it is you. Look what he said. Look at this here for yourself. Make sure you write it down. He said, look. He said, happy is Bridget that condemned not herself in that thing which she allowed. You know what? I can hang it up right now. Who allowed it? You allowed it. God said, happy is you who don't allow that lying, no good for nothing devil to come in on your premises, property, territory. That lying, no good devil that's coming in, lying to your mind, telling you, you see, that's how you get in agreement with him. Because the fact now, you're dealing with the sense realm. You're looking at it because the fact that is the fact, but it's not the truth. And here it is now, you're going with the fact. Well, yeah, you know what? It do look like that. And it do sound like that. And it do look like that. And it do shut your mouth. If it's not positive, shut up. Don't let nobody come around you with no negative energy. Don't let nobody come around you with no bad attitude. Don't let nobody come around you. You better hear God talk to you, because there's great breakthroughs getting ready to hit your house, and God intended for this thing to manifest in your life. But he sent a little girl named Bridget to make sure you understand the principles of his truth, that you don't let no devil in hell prevent, no devil in hell get in your way, no devil in hell stop. God mean what he says. So get your eyes up. Oh! You deal with it like God say, deal with it. He said, now when you condemn it, I'm going to condemn it. He said, let me tell you something. Even an undeserved, you have people saying, I curse you. I'm gonna tell you that, like that little boy said I'm gonna do it. Let them figure it out. The little boy said, I'm gonna tell you who to whoop.
Yeah.
Whoop your own. Okay, cuss for your own. So if you kiss it off, you kiss it late. Cause you know why? And even the baby had no sense to know. You acting a fool around here, and you allow me to do this here. Now you wanna whip me because of the fact you allow me to do it. That's what you're telling God. You wanna do? Ah, Jesus, it's what you allow. Hear the Holy Ghost talk to you. Because he means breakthroughs will hit your house. North, south, east, and the west. Everything God promised you is right. It ain't, listen, it's set in motion and it's in the atmosphere. And baby, you better stand your ground and you better stand still and you better not be moved. You better say, nah, I got some, man. This woman told me something, man. This woman said to me, I got to condemn it. I've been telling the Lord all this while to condemn. You know like how to be cool and talking, how to condemn it. And here it is. I have the power and authority. I didn't realize that God is expecting me to condemn everything because God has given me the power and the authority of his word. Where he said, I don't bow down to circumstance. Circumstance bow down to the word. Where he said, I don't exalt nothing above my name but my word. Now, once you get that word, then you become accountable. So let me tell you something. If you're not in a word ministry, you make sure you get it. Because God loves you just that much. You're going to walk in such victory. It's going to blow your mind. I done seen so much happening just by God gracing me to do this book tour. I done seen so much in just a little short period of time. And that ain't even a tip of the iceberg. That ain't even a tip of it. You make sure you go get your coffee. You know what? Let me start to get cooking. I'm going to pray and get out of here. You make sure you get this book in your library. Gonna set you free. You gonna stop being jealous. But why? They over there and they doing it, they doing that. But yeah, they so blessed. They You wanna go ahead and live under the law? You live under the law. I choose to live under grace. I choose to live under mercy and grace. Not deliberately doing nothing. But if it happened to happen, then I know not to condemn myself. Oh, I know to call upon the forgiveness of my Father. Look, Lord, have mercy. Get out of here. Let me get out of here. Come, let's pray. Come, Father, in the name of Jesus Christ. Come on here. Come on here. Because not, the devil won't take nothing from you. Not another nickel, not another dime, not another healing, not another deliverance. The devil won't take nothing from you. I declare and I decree in the name of Jesus Christ. Because of the fact I bind everything, all things, anything that's of the enemy. I take authority over it in the name of the Lord thy God, in the name of Jesus Christ. Through by the blood and the power of his word. I take authority in the name of Jesus. I condemn every lies. God's talking right now to you, to me, and to everybody in the world. Condemn it. You're going to condemn it right now. You're going to condemn it. I condemn every lie. I condemn every foolishness. I condemn any assignment. I condemn any plan. I condemn any all works. I condemn every word that the devil try to use to speak against others. I condemn it. Glory be to God. It's going to turn around. It's going to hit you like a boomerang. And you're going to be trying to figure out what's going on. Because that's what you thought you'd done to one. You did it to yourself. I tell you that in love. Gotta go. Now love y'all. Y'all be blessed. That's the style of the ministry of love. Y'all know I love you, right? But God love us the most. Stand up quicker. You can hang up anytime y'all want. I'ma sit right here. I'ma be alright. Hang up anytime y'all want it, baby. Though your soul you won't prevail, I got up every time I fail. But God's got me to the end. Replace every loss with a win. My life's great, keep you straight. All this hate, test your faith. My life's great, keep you straight. All this hate, test your faith. If God is for me.